All right, welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys how to do a paint out in Fusion. So we can go from this to this. So let's jump into the Fusion page and I'll show you how to do it. So with your clip selected, Shift 5 over to Fusion, and we'll break down this node tree. So first things first, we took media in and I added a planar tracker. And with the planar tracker, put it in our viewer. You start out in track mode. I put it on hybrid point area and left it on perspective. Really, I just lassoed around the text here and tracked it forwards and backwards so it would get some tracking data on the movement. It won't actually keep up in real time, but if you move to these keyframes and once the preview updates, you can see that it's locked onto those letters. So from there, you can actually just hit create planar transform. And so we have that right here in the node tree. So if you're on here and you hit it, it'll just make one in the dead space. So next thing, we're going to add the background. So instead of like painting over, I just chose the background, which you can get right up here on the toolbar. Click it, it'll add a background. And it just looks like this. You can double click. And I just used the picker tool and went over to the side of the barn, picked a color and hit OK. Then we have a polygon just before that. So with the polygon tool, they're over here. It's this third tool on the shapes. And I just drew this around. It's actually not on the reference frame, so it's a little bit out from where I originally drew it. I think we'll see where it lines up. I think it was somewhere around there. So this polygon basically tells the background to only be viewable in here. So it like punches a hole in for the key. And then the tracking data from the planar transform tells it how to move. And then I added a color corrector inside to get the lighting to change as the shot moves. It kind of gets a little bit darker towards the end, a little bit more of a shadow. So I keyframed the gain on here. So once we have the background established, we can set the polygon up. I think if we go back to the planar tracker and go to our reference frame and then hit our polygon, that's where I ended up drawing it. So if you select your polygon tool and hit 2, this will show you just the alpha channel in the viewer. And this is a good way to adjust your soft edge and your border width and actually see it not against the pixels, but on the edge of just the complete inverse. And it helps you see just how soft your edge is if you wanted to work on blending it. And you can invert it in here too if you needed to. The polygon is now controlling this background and leaves us with this. And then the planar transform tells the motion to follow along with the tracking. And with the color corrector, basically chose a spot. If we click on it, we'll see a couple keyframes, one here and one here. And to get to our keyframes, you can open the spline editor, which is on the upper right. Normally it's just a little dot here and you have to choose whichever node you're gonna adjust keyframes on. So you can see here, we adjusted our chose color corrector 1. And then you highlight and hit S, and that smooths your edit down and gives you a nice transition between the two points instead of a little bit more of a harsh line. So then if we play as it goes in, it's just a little more natural looking of a dip. And all that is the gain over here on the color corrector keyed. Then the planar transform tells the box where to go. So if we move around, you could see it's locked on from that data that we got earlier. And then essentially merging the media in into the background. So if we hover over this yellow connector, it's the background in. Green is our foreground. So we're telling the polygon background and the planar transform to be over top of the media one image. And then that goes out to our media out, which feeds back to our timeline. And that's how you add in a background, constrain it to a polygon, color correct it with keyframes, and give it tracking data to move with your shot from the planar tracker. All right, I hope that helps. Thanks for watching as always, and I'll see you guys on the next video.